right, y'all, welcome back to FLV. So today, as you see, Eminem, Yellow Brick Road. I don't know if you're going to be able to see these lyrics because of my green screen. You might not be able to see them. So you might just be seeing the picture of Eminem versus the lyrics. I know it says lyrics up here, but I got my green screen up. So sorry about that. Either way it goes, I'm still going to break it down. I can see the lyrics. All right, man. Requested, by the way. Let's check it out.
What we have to do is deal with it when these individuals are young enough, if you will, to be saved, not in a religious sense, but not to constitute what this country at times calls the throwaway children.
We seem to be approaching an age of the gross.
We all have this idea that we should move up a little bit from our parent station, and each generation should do a little bit better.
All right, come on, let's cut the bullshit enough. Let's get it started. Let's start addressing this issue and open it up. Let's take this shit back to the basement and we can discard statements that's made on this tape and its whole origin of the music that we all know and love, the music we all enjoy, the music you accuse me of trying to destroy. Let's rewind it to 89 when I was a boy on the east side of Detroit, crossing 8 Mile in the warning in the hate territory.
So I guess right now, he's defending himself because people saying you're destroying music. I had a sub or a viewer saying, hey, I'm tired of Eminem. I want some real hip hop. So even right now in 2019, people are still attacking Eminem.
I like to share a story. This is my story. You can't nobody tell it for me. Do it well and for me. I'm well aware that I don't belong here. You made that perfectly clear. I get my ass kicked. Damn near everywhere. From Bel Air Shopping Center just for stopping in there. From the black side all the way to the white side. Okay, there's a bright side. A day that I might slide.
Ain't always a black and a white side.
You may call it a pass, I call it hauling my ass through that patch of grass over them railroad tracks. Oh, them railroad tracks, them old railroad tracks, them good old notorious, so well-known tracks. So let's go back, follow the yellow brick road as we go on another episode. Journey with me as I take you through this nifty little place that I once used to call home, sweet home. Sweet home, let's go back, follow the yellow brick road as we go on another episode. Journey with me as I take you through this nifty little place that I once used to call home, sweet home. I roam the streets so much they call me a drifter. Sometimes I'd stick up a thumb just to hitchhike, just to get picked up, to get me a lifter. 8 Mile and Van Dyke, or steal a goddamn bike from somebody's backyard, drop it off at the park. That was the halfway mark to me, came back to walk back to a mama's on Chalmers. After dark to sneak me in the house when I'm kicked out my mom's. That's about the time I first met Proof for Goofy Gary on the steps at Osborne handing out some flies.
So basically he's telling a story about 8 Mile, I guess 8 Mile of Yellow Brick Road. Y'all let me know.
He was doing some talent shows at Centerline High. I told him to stop by and check us out sometime. He looked at me like I'm out my mind. Shook his head like white boys don't know how to rhyme. I spit out a line and rhyme. Birthday with first place and we both had the same rhymes that sound alike. We was on the same shit that Big Daddy Kane shit, but compound syllable sound combined. From that day we was down the ride. Somehow we knew we'd meet again somewhere down the line. So let's go back, follow the yellow brick road as we go on another episode. Journey with me as I take you through this nifty little place that I once used to call home, sweet home. Let's go back, follow the yellow brick road.
So it sounds like the yellow brick road is 8 Mile. The beat's kind of catchy. He's trying to explain himself. How did he got to this point right now? Okay.
We go on another episode. Journey with me as I take you through this nifty little place that I once used to call home, sweet home. My first year in ninth grade, can't forget that day of school. It was cool to your man until Shan came through and said that Puma's the brand because the Klan makes troops. It was rumors, but man, goddamn, they flew.
Wow, you remember MC Shan, and he said the Klan makes troops. Wasn't that like a rumor back in the day that the Klan made those shoes? That's funny.
Must have been true because man, we done banned they shoes. I had the new ones, the Cool J Iceland suede too. But we just threw them in the trash like the yesterday's news. Guess who came through next? X-Klan debut. Professor X and
notorious.
Exists in the state of red, black, and green with a key, sissies.
You remember them? S-Clan sissies.
Now with this being in the trend, we don't fit in. Crackers is out with cactus albums. Blackness is in. African symbols and medallions represent black power. And we ain't know what it meant. Me and my man Howard and Butter would go to the mall with them all over our necks like we're showing them off. Not knowing at all we was being laughed at. You ain't even half black. You ain't supposed to have that. Homie, let me grab that. And that Flavor Flav clock, we gon' have to snatch that. All I remember is meeting back at Manix's basement, saying how we hate this. I raise this, but don't the X-Clan's take this. Which reminds me, back in 89 me, when Kim broke up for the first time, she was trying to two-time me. And there was this black girl at our school who thought I was cool cause I rapped, so she was kinda eyeing me. And oh, the irony, guess what her name was. Ain't even gonna say it, plus the same color hairs.
Wow. And it's funny how he talked about how he had the Flavor Flav clock. They snatched him off saying you supposed to wear that because you're not black. You're not cool. I don't think I ever had a Flavor Flav clock, though.
First was in blue contacts and a pair of jokes. The bomb is goddamn girl in our whole school. If I could pull it, not only would I become more popular, but I would be able to piss him off at the same time. But it backfired. I was supposed to dump her, but she dumped me for this black guy. And that's the last I ever seen or heard or spoke to the old foolish pride girl. But I've heard people say they heard the tape, but it ain't that bad. But it was. I singled out a whole race, and for that I apologize. I was wrong.
Also, this was Eminem got in trouble when he said something about that girl in the song and they called him racist and all that. I forgot about that.
Follow the yellow brick road as we go on another episode. Journey with me as I take you through this nifty little place that I once used to call home, sweet home. Come on, let's go back. Follow the yellow brick road as we go on another episode. Journey with me as I take you through this nifty little place that I once used to call home, sweet home. Sweet home.
Alright, y'all, that was Yellow Brick Road, Eminem. Request, by the way. It's like it was defense. He was on trial. Trying to defend himself from stuff he did in the past. Alright, man, that was a request. FLV, a lot we just seen so far. Subscribe, hit the like button, we out.
Just like music.